Mutoid Man!
And you're getting your fix of Metal Injection!
What's up, guys? Frank here with Nick and Steve. A couple of my home slices and Mutoid Man. First of all, fuck you.
Thank you.
No, but really, congratulations, because your new album Bleeder comes out next week, and it's totally fucking killer. It's actually, in my opinion, one of the best albums of the year, but probably also one of the most wild records in your collective discography. Do you guys feel that way now that you're playing the songs live?
They're definitely a handful. Some of them get pretty wild, and they get kind of hard to play. But it's just a big laugh fest up there every time we play, you know? Nothing but smiles.
You guys seem like you're having a good time while playing them, right?
Yeah, you just got to smile through the pain, you know? It's a wild ride. You just hold on for dear life.
Does that go into the writing process, like having a good time while playing, you know? Like, it's just too boring to play. Let's just do something really creative and fun.
Yeah, I'd say collectively, Mutoid Man has a pretty good suck filter. You know, if something isn't vibing, we just kind of can it right away instead of spending too much time on it.
Do you find that you guys throw away a lot, or are you kind of like musical hoarders who like to work it in and try to figure out a place for it all?
I definitely think, like, if there's a good idea but it's not initially working, sometimes it'll get revisited when we're writing a completely different song, just out of the blue. It'll be like, oh, you know what would work? Like that weird riff that we wrote like 3 weeks ago that we recorded on our phone, you know?
Right. Yeah. And then even when we were a bi-coastal band, there was like maybe an hour's worth of videos that we would send to each other of just playing riffs. You know, me in the morning just sitting in my underwear playing guitar. I mean, we can't part with those.
So we
have to keep that stuff around.
And when is that going to make its way to the internet?
Home videos, the Mutoid home video. It's like the Pantera one where it's nothing but tits and like smashing shit and Steve in his underwear.
There are obviously elements of Cave-In and Conversion there, but it's something very unique on its own. You know what I mean? There's like, and I think that comes from the fearlessness of being really weird and silly. Where does that weird and silly inspiration come from with you guys?
I'd say each other. We're all kind of a bunch of goofballs, in a good way. But it's like all of us trying to keep up with each other and trying to keep up with Ben mostly. So it's just like, it's like a, okay, all right, yeah, okay, we'll try and play that fast. Or like, okay, what? How is that, how are you counting that? Like, why does that sound so weird, you know? It's I think it's like a collective inspiration for everyone, maybe.
Yeah, it's like mathematics for monkeys, you know? We're just kind of like, what are you doing there? Counting it out can be really fun, and then Ben will be like, oh, well, now that you're comfortable playing this in 12-7, let's flip it to 11-4 for just four bars and go halftime and blah, 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 blah. And, you know, just constantly trying to trip each other up. But for the greater of the song.
You guys mentioned Ben, who I consider one of the greatest drummers in metal right now. Can you tell us something he's bad at?
Handjob karaoke.
Agreed.
Handjob karaoke is where you're getting a hand job and trying to sing karaoke.
It's very popular in Japan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, it's not on you. Who else would be?
So now we know how you guys pass time on tour.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, we don't go to these places. We just do it in the van with each other, but...
What's your karaoke jam?
Oh, God. I don't know. I try to butcher Dio as much as I can. I can't sing anything like the dude, but it's fun to sing.
You're getting called you know, side projects, super groups, stuff like that. How do you guys feel about that? I mean, it's kind of come a long way since then, right?
Yeah, it definitely feels more like a band now, especially with Nick in the picture. It's understandable. I mean, I think when you have a band that is formed by two people who play in bands that have been around as long as Cave-In and Converge have been doing it, like 20 plus years, that's just normally how people are going to perceive something. But hopefully with this new record, it kind of establishes that, you know, it's a little bit more of a project. We're also treating it more than just a project too, you know, by, you know, playing shows, going out and touring and doing stuff like this to, you know, sort of spread the word. Yeah, lots of Dobus. Plenty of Dobus.
Converge, Cave-In, Mutoid, World Tour. When's the starting date of that?
That would be awesome.
Yeah. Wow.
I heard it's coming this Thrashtober. I don't know about you guys.
Rocktober, Thrashtober. I like Thrashtober better.
Well, we've been joking about trying to put together something called Incest Fest, which would involve all things Cave-In, Converge. So we'd get, let's see, Doom Riders in the mix. Old Man Gloom. Clouds, Zozobra.
All Pigs Must Die.
Yep. We're talking like a 2 or 3 day thing. Kid Kilowatt.
Ooh, yeah.
The list goes on.
I think people would actually show up to that.
No Incest joke. Fest. Book
yeah.
it.
Okay, yeah. Done. Coming soon. Incest Fest. This Thrashtober. No, but really, check out Bleeder. It comes out next week. It's a fantastic record. If you don't own it, you're fucking up.